Who's got this, these three outputs for me, Kyler?
I got 1, 3, and 5. 7, I got 7.
Yeah, 7.
3, 7.
2 times 2 equals 4, 1, plus 3 equals 7.
Yep.
2 plus 3, 4 plus 3. Okay, 7. All right. Tricky stuff, huh?
No.
But I want you. But I want. I know. Sarcasm. I want to show you that what we're learning today is not a lot more complicated than this, but I'm having to do. Okay. You just kind of repackaged into a shinier package. It's just a slightly different notation. All right. So. Here, you see I've traded out the y for this f parentheses x, okay? If you don't know the answer to this, I'm not surprised, because have you ever seen this before?
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Oh, actually,
so have?
I have. I know what it is, let me tell you. The f stands for function.
F does stand for function.
Wow.
It's true. We can change this around, though, but that's why kind of the default is f. It stands for function, that's true. What I want you to do, okay, so maybe you do know, maybe you have seen it, I'm surprised. Maybe you haven't, maybe you haven't. Either way, either write the answer that you know is the correct answer, or take your best guess at what you think this thing means. Right, see f parentheses x, what is f parentheses 2? Just take your best.
Function times.
Not your best shouting out your answer. Write on your notes your best guess of what you think it is. Or if you do know what it is, write what it is. Right? Like do what it's asking you to do then. So, what do you guys think? Somebody think about that. What do that means? Nick?
It basically means if the x is 2, now the equation would change.
Oh, I got
it. Where the x is on the equation, shown up there. Well,
okay, so, I mean, do we have to do something about that, or is there something we can do? Okay, so f of 2 means what? To do what?
It means that if you multiply 2 by the input, which is x, yeah, if you put it like that, 2 times parentheses 2.
Oh, you put 2 there where x was,
plus 3. And that's what the equation is.
What do you mean that's what the equation is? What do you mean by that? Okay. Well, that's correct. All right? Plug in, you see how 2 is in the place of x, it's just saying put 2 in the place of x. It's the same question as what I put up as you walked in, right? Like, here's the input, give me the output, right? So maybe by that's the equation, you mean that's the output, right?
Okay. I'm gonna explain.
So, it says use function f, put an input of 2, what do you get? That's the output. F of 2 is 7. F of 2 is 7. So f of x, you might notice I'm saying f of x. That's how you say it. And you don't, it's not f times x, it's not f times 2. F of the function, there's a function of x, meaning that x is the input. Okay? So plug in 2, what do you get? You get 7. 2 is the input. F of 2 is the output. The output is 7. Just input out. Just a different way to say input and output. Okay.
How come we have to have the f?
Okay. So why would we have an f? Why don't we just keep it with y? I mean, why wasn't hurting anybody? So how come we're just changing it to f? Okay. There's a couple of reasons. We can give functions different names. F does stand for function. Like I said, that's why it is the letter that we choose to use. I'm just going to write down a function. I'll use f. If I have several functions, though, I might choose to use several different names so that they can be distinguished one from each other. Now, you have names, right? I can call you by name. Did you hear the horrible things that Ethan did? So you know what I'm talking about.
He got named Ethan.
Nope.
Oh,
that was a terrible thing he did?
Yep.
I don't think Ethan did that. It was very passive thing that happened to him. So, what does this mean? What does g of negative 5 mean? Molly?
A function called g with the input of negative 5.
Couldn't say it any better. A function called g with the input of negative 5. Do you see it? A function called g?
Yep.
There it is right there. Function called g. Okay, so this, by using function notation, we kind of can say a lot with a little. With just a few pen strokes. You know I'm talking about the function g, not the function f. If we always use just y, these would both be y equals and y equals, and it'd be hard to tell the difference between them. Now we can tell the difference, what's called f, what's called g. Okay? With a few more pen strokes, I can tell you that I want you to take the function g and make the input negative 5 and see what you get for the output. So if we use the function g and we give the input negative 5, what's going to be our output?
29.
29?
Negative 29.
You said 29.
Do you not hear the little?
Did I not hear you say the word negative?
I was
the quiet.
I was like,
did anyone's ever said it?
I was like this.
You said 29?
I was like 29.
No, I didn't pick up on that. That's crazy me. Okay, so the input is negative 5, the output is negative 29. Catching on?
Yep.
Here.
So it doesn't matter what end of letter it is, it just needs the
Yeah, the letter that we choose, it doesn't have any meaning. It's just a name. Okay. Kind of like our names, those are our names. We don't think about what they mean all the time. We just have a name. So you know what my name is, what your name is, I know your name is different, and I can distinguish you from each other. Colin?
So the function be called x or y?
Well, we wouldn't call it x, probably. Like, let's look at some examples of how you could do what you said. We call it y. We call it y of x. No reason we can't give it to y. So maybe y of x equals 2x minus 8. So I wouldn't call it x of x. That would be very confusing.
Well, could you change the x, x of g?
Sure. Now.
Yeah.
If you're doing g of x for 20 years or something, and then somebody says writes x of g, that can get you a little backwards. But absolutely, it follows the schema of function notation. Here's the name of the function outside the parentheses. Here's the thing that we call the input. So x of g would have to look like g squared plus 20 or something like that. Like, that would be called g.
There.
We all heard it. G squared plus 2. So that would be the function called x or the input called g.
Alright. Did you get it all?
No. Any more questions? I love that question. That was a great question.
What? You got it out?
Yeah, that was nice. Good question. Can we still call a function y? Sure, we can. Can we call a function x? Yes, kind of a good way we could. So let's see if we're getting the idea of the basics of function notation. Here we have three functions. What are the names of these three functions? Clint?
F with the notion x. Oh, no.
Well, it would just be called f. So what would the other ones be called?
T.
No matter what they are.
Oh, h.
So they're f?
You're just saying the letter.
F. That's the name. Okay?
What's
that?
So we gotta put those in.
I want you to, there's f, g, and h. I want you to tell me what h of 2 is and f of 6 is. Okay, well, if you just did a couple of examples together already, see if you're catching on. If not, then we'll have two more examples here. H of 2 means go to a function called h and make the input 2, so negative 5 times 2. F, the function f. Make the x 6. So negative 18 plus 4, negative 14.
Do we write f 6 like f times, or can you just write f? F of 6 equals negative 14.
Sure.
Is that what we
write
for the answer though?
Equals.
Yeah, that would be like a very succinct answer. F of 6 equals negative 14 means I put 6 into f. and I found that the result, the output, was negative 14.
20.
Good. That's a good thing to say.
Oh, that seems like super simple, like fifth grade.
It is.
Well, the math's not complicated. It's just we want to get this notation down.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, what do you think people, if they make a mistake about this, about understanding this notation, what do you think they might get confused about and think this means?
Notation.
F times 6 equals negative 14.
F times 6. What's F? And how do I multiply by 6?
It's a notation.
Some number that I don't, like letter that I don't know what it is.
That's
and
what I
think. 14,
yeah.
So,
notation?
So, it's not multiplication. Not at all.
No, it didn't.
Huh? No. It has nothing to do with multiplication. Unless the function has multiplication in it. Otherwise, this has nothing to do with multiplication.
Unless it said time.
Right. And the difficult thing about this is just learning that even in math, just like in every other subject area I can think of, things can look like they do in other situations, but in a different context, it means something different. And it's like a word that's spelled the same, but has different meanings.
Mm-hmm.
Like the word wind, the word wind. Should I read it wind or wine? It depends.
Mm.
Depends.
Depends on what sentence it's in, what it's talking about. Do you wind up a clock? Or do you
wind?
You wind up a clock.
Well,
wind
up a clock.
Was the wind blowing?
Yes, the wind was blowing.
Wind was blowing, put your feet down. This is not your living room.
I'm a rebel.
Rebels in
the
office.
Like Wayne.
Like Wayne.
Please stop talking.
Shut your mouth, Clint.
All right, so f of x equals 2x plus 3. That means that I could write my table like this, x and f of x. Okay. F of x is the same as y. It replaces y in every context. Okay. And then the table would look exactly the same if you say f of x. We could. Graph. Now our graph paper looks like x-axis and f of x-axis instead of y-axis.
What would you put on the f of x-axis?
Just the same thing as y.
Oh, so it's just practically another word for y.
It can be.
Can you go back one?
Or it could be.
We'll find.
Thanks so much.
Clint, why are you moving?
The next time that you're talking about brain instead of writing stuff down,
yeah.
It won't go back.
And then.
So f of x just is like a different word for y. Now, if you call this the y-axis, even though we're talking about f of x, of course, it's not. Nobody's going to get upset about that. Okay. But you may see that. Some people will write that, f of x-axis. That means the output, that means the input. So perfectly valid way to draw your graph paper. So someone describe to me how I would graph this function.
You would draw a dot at 5.
Okay, so that's our, what's that called?
Point. Oh, that's our y-axis intercept.
That's
fx-intercept.
Okay, cool. The f of x intercept.
Yes.
Or y-intercept. If you said y-intercept, I would have said yes, just as emphatically.
Yeah.
Okay, now what?
And then you go up by 2. And over to the right by 3.
Like how
you said, to the right?
To the right, to the
right. What I did was I went over 3 first and then I went on up 2. Can you do
that's
that?
That's
okay.
Yeah.
I
didn't think that makes a little more sense, because that's kind of more input-output minded. Change the input, changes the output.
Yeah.
All right, so everybody's on board?
Yep.
Yes, no.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's unnecessary. Why do you need to do that?
If we're concerned with unnecessary things, Kyler, maybe
you should step out.
No.
I'm paying attention.
As you're telling Clint what to do?
After you repeated it, I had to make you clear to it.
Oh, thank you so much. Let's say g of x equals 2/3 x plus 7. Now, what's going to be similar about these two graphs? Or our graph? G of x.
On the same up, they're going to have the same slope.
They're going to be parallel.
They're going to be parallel? Right? Those, that similarity makes them parallel. They're going to have the same slope.
And g of x is going to be f of x in this case.
G of x is going to be f of x?
Mm. Yeah, like it's going to be the y-intercept.
Like, I'm not sure I follow.
Like, it would, like what we did
well,
for
g, so there would be like a g of x axis.
Yeah.
F of x axis, and we could put the g of x axis on top of that one. This is where it gets kind of messy. We can just call it the y axis. That would be fine. Okay. Yes?
Okay, so, and it's not a fraction, so how do we do that? Because I know one is just 1/1, but that's not, it's wrong. So I don't know. I guess it's just a question on how to do that.
Okay, well, let's just we'll go back it up a little bit here and talk about that kind of thing. Heather, please stop saying anything at all. No more words from you right now.
Yes, sir.
Also, Clint, I don't need your help with Kyler. F of x, let's say it equals, would 2x be a good example of what you're talking about?
Yeah.
2x minus 3. Okay? Really, you don't want to be procedure-minded. You want to understand what this function does, right? So let's find a couple of points. X and y are actually x and f of x. So let's try 0. That'd be pretty easy. What do we get if we put 0 into f of x? We get -3. That's why we know the y-intercept is -3. It's easy to see what would happen if we plug in 0. And since this isn't a fraction, it'd be really easy to just plug in 1.
Yeah.
Yep.
2 times 1 is 2 minus 3.
-1.
Now notice, I just went over to the right 1, right, an x of 1, and -1 is 2 above that. The slope is 2 over 1. Over 1, over 1, and up 2.
So that's what I was trying to tell you.
Tyler, those are those words you talked about?
I see smiles.
So again, these two guys are going to have the same slope. What are they going to have that's different? Sim?
Well, I have a question.
Yeah?
What's the difference between f of x and y?
No
difference.
Then why don't we just say y?
Let's
go all the way back to when I explained why.
Sim, this is the question that we don't need.
Because, I mean, you may not love it. This is why it's used. Because now we can give some, instead of y equals -3x plus 4, and y equals -1/2x plus 2, and y equals -5x, we can give them all different names, just like all of you have different names. Right? So this one has the name f, this one has the name g, and this one has the name h. So I can stand over here, I don't have to point at them anymore, I can just say, hey, look over there, function f, right? And you know to look right there, function f. And if I write f of 6, nothing. If that function was just called y and I wanted to put 6 in for x, it would take a lot more than this. To tell you that I would have to set up a table and then put that in the x column, or I'd have to write out a sentence that says plug 6 into the function, or you see what I mean? I can tell you that I want you to put 6 into this function with just a few pen strokes. So it's kind of efficient, and it helps us give different names to functions. Right? Molly?
With giving them different names, why couldn't you, instead of f x equals -3x plus 4, why can't you do f equals -3x plus 4?
Just because of this, essentially, I want to be able to show you, plug this
it
in.
It tells you which input
you
what
get.
The input is, yeah. What's a plug in for the input? I know that f of 6 means the number that I get out of the function when I plug 6 in. There's a lot of information packed into just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pen strokes. And actually, sometimes if we're in a hurry or we're not really concerned about plugging functions or numbers into the function, we just want to talk about the function. Sometimes we will just say f, f equals. But
that's
later, good. If I put f parentheses x, you know that means, or f parentheses 2, that means plug 2 into f.
Yeah, so you know what the input is.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's just a new notation that we all just agree to, and it enables us to do a few other things. It's kind of like a new version of an app that you like with a few more features, right? Why did they change the app to have those features? Well, because they're kind of convenient for different reasons. And that's true of function notation. It has a few more features than just y apps.
Same.
So what would be different about these two functions, or these two graphs? They'd have the same slope, but they would have what?
A different y-intercept.
So where would this graph be in comparison to this graph?
Two above.
Two above. I could just take this function, and I could shift it up two.
You can go over
two. Up two, over two, and up three. Or over three, and up two.
Perfect.
What a dandy.
What
a whale of a
That
is a dandy.
Talk about it this way. Now, g of x is just like f of x, right?
Right. No.
It's just like f of x, except it's two more.
Oh.
F of x plus two. That's what g of x is. What if I told you that h of x equals f of x minus 4? How would that look compared to f of x, Ethan?
It would start on the 1,
yeah,
and then it would be the same.
And then everything else would be the same. It would just be shifted down with 4, which puts it at a minus with a 1. Right?
Right.
I want somebody to, think about this for a second, and I'm going to ask somebody to come up here. This is the graph for f of x. What was the graph of f of x minus 3?
The down?
No, I want you to think about it. I'm going to ask somebody to come up here and do it.
I want to do it, please.
Kyler, come on up. You over-energetic, crazy guy. Or do you want to write it on the board?
I'll just write it like this. He doesn't need to hold on.
Right there.
No,
right there?
It's too low. Wait, no.
Okay. We're just gonna put a mark right there.
No, it's negative 1.
What are you doing?
That last one was negative. That's not right.
It's pretty close. Let me see if I can just clean it up a bit. But also, what about this guy right here?
It needs to go up one. Oh, shnikes, my bad.
One below or one above that?
Above.
Right, because remember, this function, it's not saying that it has a y-intercept of 3. It's saying its y-intercept at every other point is 3 below what f of x is. We start with f of x and we subtract 3 from there. So like this point is x comma f of x. That's the y value. If I were to subtract 3 from that, it would put it down 1, 2, 3 right there. Same for this one. Like this point right here would move down 1, 2, 3. And it would be right there. This guy here. Move down 1, 2, 3. And this green graph of g of x would be exactly the same as f of x, but move down 1, 2, 3.
Todd, I got that so right.
Will f of x and g of x ever cross each other?
Yes.
No.
No, because they're parallel, so it's impossible.
Okay, well,
look at it, they're not parallel.
Yeah, lines are parallel, right?
Right?
So curves can't be really parallel. But they're not going to cross, because you might think, well, this one's going up so fast right there, you know, it's getting so steep that it might cross this blue one. See how close they are?
Yeah. But no, that's because you drew it wrong.
It's a copy and pasted it. no matter what, no matter how steep they are, no matter how steep they are, they're still, any 2 points.
They're gonna meet up.
Are three away from each other. That distance right there, always three.
But it's gonna end up hitting each other one point.
Don't talk.
It won't. Never.
I don't want to hear that either.
This one's getting steep, but this one's getting exactly the same steepness. Right? Now, if you're flying a plane and you made the exact same moves,
I mean,
but you started out
below
the other plane, you just get pretty close, but you're never going to actually touch.
Like if they race.
Exactly.
Who really raced? I raced twice once.
Not race,
because
one's trying to go
fast. I chased the bird.
Well, we had a boring race where they're both always going the same speed all the time, right?
I was dogfighting.
I didn't eject them.
You the dog's team, and I'm not
green.
I shot a dog.
We're losing focus.
I got some.
Yeah, Clint, shut your mouth.
I
know.
You ready to move on?
Yeah,
thank you. Appreciate your generosity.
You're welcome.
See if we can rise to the challenge.
We get
here.
This.
Stu. Notice the plus two is inside the front.
Oh, this is easy.
That is just three.
But example is F of three. Now three is the same as three. Let's use knight four.
What?
What does F of four mean?
Function of four.
Function called
f of 4. Well, you put in 4, so let's put in 4. 3 times 4 plus 8, 12 plus 8, 20, right?
How did you get 4?
I just made it up. It's just an example, and the point I'm making with this example is whatever you see in the parentheses, you plug in for x.
But then why did you have f that right around there?
So I'm helping you understand why I'm about to write what I'm about to write. So your answer should be, f of x plus 2 should be 3x plus
14. Yeah. No, why did you choose 14?
Okay, so it should be plus 14. You might have plus 10.
You should have plus 14.
Because whatever you see in the parentheses goes in for x. So in for x, let's put
that's what I did.
X plus 2. And how do we multiply the 3 by the x plus 2?
Oh, 3 times 2. Oh, that's 3x.
Distribute, yeah. 3x plus 14.
Oh, that's so sweet. That is
distributive property.
Distributive property. That's what I was looking for a while ago when I said, how do we multiply this together? Distributive property.
And then, but you forgot something.
Whatever
you
want.
You forgot the f parentheses x plus 2 equals 3x.
Okay, f of x plus 2 equals 3x plus 14.
Yeah, bud. Okay, we got this down. We're good to do some homework.
You think you got it?
Yeah.
We have
you think you're up for a.
Oh, no.
For a challenge.
Challenge?
Yeah.
No, I have to finish my test.
I'm just going to put it, I'll just put the challenge up there and you can have at it if that's what you want to do.
Oh, you get extra credit if you do this
one.
You don't have homework?
Yes. You get extra credit if you do this one.
But we do have
sweet
homework.
Peaches.
Yes.
Sweet.
How much extra credit?
As much as I give you.
So like 5 each? So we can just plug in any number for those equations?
It's up to you to figure out.
Wait, that's the challenge?
It's a good idea to look back at the example we just did and remind yourself, whatever you see inside the parentheses is what goes in for x in the function.
Okay, I get it. You got it. Alright.
There's your homework 5.4 and an extra credit problem. If you do the extra credit, please write it on a separate piece of paper, write extra credit on it so that I don't miss it.
Crap.
It's not on the same page as your homework. He is the